CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So friends, let's join in Dhwani Shala class 4.
Hello children, how are you today? I'm your friend Madhura. I'll be talking to you in English. It's fun to talk in English. Difficult, you say? No, not at all. And if you listen carefully, you'll understand all that I say. I'm sure you remember last year when you were in class 3. You cannot go to school right now because of the coronavirus. But don't worry. After some time, schools will reopen. You will be very happy to go back to school, play with your friends and meet a new teacher and of course, learn many new things. Let me tell you something funny I did today. I was feeling a bit bored, so I went to the big mirror above the sink. I looked in the mirror, I looked at my own face and I focused only on my nose. I looked and looked and it seemed to me that maybe I had a big nose. I could see the shine on the skin and the two holes which became a little larger as I breathed in. And as I looked at my nose seemed really large. Is that how it looks? I thought. Is that how people see me? I blinked and my nose looked normal again. Phew, what a relief. You should try that sometime. Oh, and I want to know, what is the word for nose in your mother tongue? Oh my, so many answers. Well, it shows you how many languages we have in India. Today, we are going to listen to a poem, Noses, by one of my favorite poets, Alan Fisher. Do you remember the poem Bird Talk in your class 3 textbook? That was a nice poem, wasn't it? Yes, you are right. Alan Fisher wrote that poem too. If you have Marigold Book 4 with you, open it to Unit 2. You will find the poem Noses on page 18. If you don't have the textbook with you, it doesn't matter. You can always download it or maybe you can get a photocopy of it. But meanwhile, you can listen to the poem.
Noses. I looked in the mirror and looked at my nose. It's the funniest thing, the way it grows. Stuck right out where all of it shows, with two little holes where the breathing goes. I looked in the mirror and saw in there the end of my chin and the start of my hair, and between there isn't much space to spare with my nose, like a handle sticking there. If ever you want to giggle and shout and can't think of what to do it about, just look in the mirror and then, no doubt, you'll see how funny your nose sticks out.
That was the poem. You know, I really love it when the child says that the nose is one feature that sticks out of the face. I mean, features like eyes and mouth and chin seem to be flat on the face, but the nose really comes out at you. People have so many different kinds of noses. Some are small, some are round, like a button. Some are long, some have a curve at the tip. Some are, oh, I could go on and on. But there are two things common to all of them. One, they are in the middle of the face. Two, they have two holes to breathe. Now, let's learn a new word. Nostril. Repeat after me. Nostril. Very good. Once again, please. Nostril. Yes. You have two nostrils. One is the right nostril and one is the left nostril. With your right hand, touch your right nostril. Excellent. Sit straight now. Keep your left hand down Now, we will all do a breathing exercise. Bring your right thumb on your right nostril. Close your right nostril with this thumb. Breathe in with your left nostril till your inside is filled with air. Now, using your two fingers, close the left nostril. Remove your thumb and breathe through your right nostril. Repeat this exercise slowly at first. Great! So now you know a new word, nostril. Let me spell it. NOSTRIL. Repeat after me. NOSTRIL. Nostril. Okay. So now another word. Bridge. You all know what a bridge is, I'm sure. It is a kind of road made of bamboo or cement to connect the two banks of a river or the two edges of a huge gap or to connect two mountains over a deep valley. The bridge of your nose is what you balance your spectacles on. When your grandfather puts on his spectacles, they rest on the bridge of his nose. This brings me to another word, nose ring. Quite simple, isn't it? It is a ring that girls and women wear on the nose. In some cultures, men also wear it. Let's spell it. NOSERING. Nose ring. And finally, we have nose bleed. Sometimes, children, if you are out on a hot day for a long time, you may notice a little blood coming out of your nose. This is nosebleed. You have to lie down so that the nose is positioned upwards. But don't be afraid. A nosebleed does not last very long. What else can your nose do? With your eyes, you can see. With your ears, you can hear. With your nose, you can smell. That's right, children. You can smell with your nose. Let's plan a fun activity. With the help of your father or mother, gather a few things from the kitchen and around you. These must have a smell. Collect things such as soap, apple, rose, curry leaves, detergent, used socks. Ew! Yes, my dear children, used socks. Also, pickle, pepper. Oh, the list is endless. You may now call your brother or sister or anyone else. Make him or her sit down. Tie a handkerchief or a scarf on their eyes so that they can't see. Now, bring each item close to the person's nose. Ask him or her to guess what it is. Clap your hands if the guess is correct. Next, ask the person which three things he or she liked the most. Write them down on a piece of paper and draw a small heart next to the items. Now, it's your turn. What? You thought the game was over? No, not at all. We move on to the memory game. You and the other person go to another room, taking the paper with you, and make a list of all the items. You already have the three favorite ones. You only have to add to the list. Could you remember all the items? You can play the same game involving taste, but that is for another day. Let's listen to the first stanza of the poem again.
I looked in the mirror and looked at my nose. It's the funniest thing, the way it grows. Stuck right out where all of it shows, with two little holes where the breathing goes.
Oh, I can smell something. Someone is cooking. I'm sure, children, that you too can guess what is being cooked at your homes just from the smell. We have a special name for it. Aroma. We use it specifically for food. For example, I like going to the bakery in the mornings, for I love the aroma of freshly baked bread, the aroma of spices filled in the kitchen. Yes, so aroma is for the smell of food. For flowers, we use the word fragrance, as in the fragrance of roses or the fragrance of jasmine. Did you understand the difference, children? The aroma of butter melting into ghee, the fragrance of flowers in the temple. Okay? Now, for the very bad smells, we use the word stench. Stench rhymes with the bench. Stench rhymes with bench. So, it is easy to remember. The smell of rotting vegetables caused a stench. When no one cleared the dustbins for a week, there was a horrible stench. So, children, our noses breathe air in and breathe air out. They also help us to differentiate between smells. Now, let us remember some smells. The smell of the first rain in summer. Oh my goodness, I am always happy to recall the smell of rain falling on mud. Of course, when you have a cold, your nose is blocked and your sense of smell will be slightly affected. But have you thought about how the smell actually reaches your nose? Ask your parent to take a perfume or a sanitizer and spray it, not directly in front of you, but a little to the side. But even so, you can smell the fragrance. This is because the tiny droplets of the sprayed liquid travel through the air to reach your nose. That is why you need to wear a mask. For if someone who has COVID sneezes near you, the tiny droplets carrying the virus would reach your nose and enter your body. You would be affected by the virus. Promise me, children, that you will wear the mask and cover your nose and mouth. Even when you go to school, you will wear a mask. But back to the memory of smell. The smell of freshly cut grass. Oh, wonderful. The smell of fish. Ah, some like it, some don't. Listen to a very short poem. You can easily learn it and teach your younger brother or sister. Repeat after me. I have a little nose, I have a little nose, I have a little nose, and I have a little chin. I have a little chin, I have a little chin, I have a little chin, and I have a little mouth to put my dinner in. Shall we say that again? I have a little nose. I have a little nose. I have a little nose and I have a little chin. I have a little chin. I have a little chin. I have a little chin and I have a little mouth to put my dinner in. But, you know, your nose also warns you of danger. How, you may ask? Think of a house on fire. The whole house is on fire, but it must have started as a small fire with a little smoke. So, children, if you smell smoke or smell gas, be alert and tell your elders. Do not try to go near the source of the smell. Ask others if they can smell it too. Well, children, we have been talking of noses, human noses. But what about animals and birds? I have always wondered whether birds can smell food. Science tells us that most birds do not have any great sense of smell, but they depend on their eyes to locate food. However, some birds such as vultures, kiwis, and parrots have a well-developed sense of smell. Imagine that. As for animals, there again you find a lot of variety. Well, children, I am sure you have seen an elephant or a picture of an elephant. An elephant walks slowly, turning its head slightly. It has a long, very long nose called a trunk. Very good. When an elephant walks, its trunk moves gently from side to side, back and forth, gathering new smells and information. The nostrils of the elephant are located at the tip of the trunk. They have a great sense of smell. They can locate food which is miles away. One more fact, children. Elephants draw in water through their nostrils and squirt it in their mouth. Now please don't try putting water in your nose. Sometimes, when having a bath, a little water gets in your nose. How you sneeze and cough. But an elephant's nose is special. Snakes now. Snakes don't have noses like we do. They have nostrils to breathe, but a snake smells with its tongue. It flicks its tongue in and out of its mouth. The tongue picks up all kinds of smell in the air. When the tongue goes back into the mouth, it touches a special part on the roof of the tongue, which tells the snake about the smell. Okay, children, now I want you to pick up a pencil and draw a fish. Will you do it for me? A fish, please. Okay, now look at the fish you have drawn. A fish has eyes and a mouth, but no nose. So, how does a fish breathe? It breathes through its gills. You can see the gills just behind the ears making small movements as it breathes in and out. Now, you and I will measure our nose. Use your thumb and forefinger to touch both ends of your nose, top and bottom. Without changing the measure, hold your thumb and finger at the top and bottom of your forehead, where your hair starts and your nose begins. Did you notice it is the same? Again, without changing the measurements, put your thumb and finger at the lower part of your nose and lower part of your chin. This is also the same. Now, let us listen to the second stanza of the poem once again.
I looked in the mirror and saw in there the end of my chin and the start of my hair, and between there isn't much space to spare with my nose, like a handle sticking there.
Haha, the poet says that the nose is like a handle on the face. Yes, it is, because it sticks out. Have you heard the phrase, win by the nose? Suppose there are two fast runners in the race. They are both equally good. They run very fast. Their feet touch the finishing line exactly at the same time. So, who wins? Well, if one person has put her face forward, her nose wins. That means she wins. Now, let's look at rhyming words. The word nose rhymes with a flower. Rose, good. The word nose rhymes with something at the end of your feet. Toes, excellent. The word nose rhymes with something that means changes from small to big, just like a seed into a plant. Grows, very good. The word nose rhymes with something which is the opposite of comes, that is, goes. So we have nose, rose, toes, grows, and goes. Now, think of rhyming words for hair. The word hair rhymes with something you sit on. What could it be? Sofa? No. Stool? No. Chair. Hair rhymes with chair. Next, the word hair rhymes with the opposite of here. The opposite of here, which is there. The word hair rhymes with the opposite of dark, which is fair. Can I give you a little homework, children? I want you to think of rhymes for the word chin. C-H-I-N. Chin. Now, let's listen to the whole poem.
Noses. I looked in the mirror and looked at my nose. It's the funniest thing, the way it grows. Stuck right out where all of it shows, with two little holes where the breathing goes. I looked in the mirror and saw in there the end of my chin and the start of my hair, and between there isn't much space to spare with my nose, like a handle sticking there. If ever you want to giggle and shout and can't think of what to do it about, just look in the mirror and then, no doubt, you'll see how funny your nose sticks out.
Fine. It's time to say goodbye now. But we'll surely talk again. Till then, keep safe, wash your hands frequently, and remember, wear a mask that completely covers your mouth and your nose. Bye!
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti and Jagbandhu Jana. This program was recorded by Bati Langlingdo and technically assisted by Soumya Malik. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.